Hey, what is up, YouTube? How's it going, everyone? How's the holidays? And what up, y'all? It's Sparky Marky Mark here, and I'm back to do a G-Shock review and unboxing, which you're gonna be seeing, of course, is this. Now, what is this, boys and girls? For all you generations, including young bucks and collectors out there, know what this is. This is an extra large DW 6900. Wait, this ain't your typical 6900. It is big, dude. It's an extra large 6900 design, of course. Everything's changed except for the face, which you're going to be seeing in a moment. You're going to be seeing the box opened, and you're going to see the case. You're going to see it for a sec. But I'm going to show you a little music that I'm going to be playing representing this unboxing. This is Avicii featuring Aloe, or Aloeblacc, with a song, Wake Me Up, in which this song that you're about to listen to should have been used in the ending credits of Iron Man 3. Yes, this song should have been used in the ending credits for Iron Man 3, in my opinion, and it's a great song. And this watch you're about to see was released in August or the fall of 2013, celebrating G-Shock's 30th anniversary. I'll leave you the link in the description box down below, and tell me what you th and leave your comments and such, and what do you think of this piece? Really, from the initial introduction in 1994 as the DW 6600, that it was different. The bezel is remained the same as the shape of it, and it would be like 19 years later we would get a bigger G-Shock, but it's 18 years after 1995 as well. So you're gonna be seeing this particular watch. So listen, y'all, and very carefully, y'all. Module number 3220. Multiple languages and such. Wrapping, y'all, get the wrapping out of there. Voila, y'all. This is what you're looking at. The GDX 6900. Of course. The GDX 6900 FA-8B. That's right, y'all. This is what you're looking at. Smoky gray color. Clear, skeletonized. You can see it. Oh yeah. Well, let's see the buckle. Well, it says Casio China, but remember, y'all, this is Japan item. But the buckle is great. No lie there. No lie. Buttons are big, y'all. And these have big screws. Like it's younger brother, like it's big, like it's older brother from say 18 years, but it was released in 2013. It was released in 1995 and 2013. That's 18 years, but from the 90s, say hello. But I'm gonna show you a little bit later with that. Let's take a look at it, y'all. Little time, stopwatch, my favorite, the timer. And alarms, 1, 2, snooze, signal, back to your alarm one, back to your time. And let's see a little something. Whoa, what did I just press? Illumination, y'all. Not your typical blue light, it's your LED light, y'all. Brightness, that's what it is, y'all. And the dimensions are so 3D, so big, you couldn't imagine. And no need to be doing this. I don't think it does any. I don't think it does that. But again, look at it. It's so great. But I'm gonna have a little bit strong feelings, 10-to-1, that I don't know if these 6900 jelly smoky gray clear bands have been improved. As I said in my previous video, that I don't know if G-Shock had made their mistakes in the past, over the past many years, leading to this moment that even until 2018, or who knows, so that I don't even know these are resistant to ultraviolet lights and also exposure to water and sun. I mean, I don't know if they improved it. And these, of course, I mean, really, these are big, everything's gotten big. And I mean, seriously, you can't deny this existence of the piece, of course. And let's see a little comparison to its older brother. Like you've seen before, these have spring bars, like right underneath there, where I'm pointing. That's it, the spring bars. Like its younger brother, big screws. And let's see a little feel in comparison to the OG. Come on, y'all, let's take a look. You see them sandwiched side by side? Oh yeah. Mm-hmm. You see it side by side? Well, let's play it again, heck. Okay, like the older one from 1995, small buttons, like you normally see on the G-Shocks in the 90s and 2000s. Like it's big, like its younger brother, big and big buttons, big screws, big everything. Dimensions are big. Seriously, you can't deny it. And well, maybe a little bit short, but the band for the 6900. The OG one is like longer, but it's smaller. Well, this one is huge. And they both say G. Let's light them up together on the side, y'all. Let's light them up together, y'all. Pause that, y'all. Pause that. Let me do it again. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, 1, 2 seconds. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. You could hold it as long as you want. Let's do it one more time. Awesome, isn't it? Very cool. See them like this. Mm-hmm. A little bit closer is proximity. No lie there. But all in all, these are great pieces to collect or to wear. Or you can like redesign these, you know, like it change the bands or anything. And let's see the size. Heck, let's see what's the height and length of these pieces. Heck. Let's see how this big boy is. Oh, 56.2 millimeters. And let's see its older brother. Let me see something. Wait. millimeters. Let's see the height as well. 53.1. Let's see its younger brother, how big it is. 57.7. Wow, this is bigger. But the 6900 always remained an icon to the world of watches. But the main icon is the DW5000. That's where it started. This is representing the 90s. Again, 1995. This is 2013, celebrating G-Shock's 30th anniversary. So yeah. I'm not gonna say I don't even know if Casio and G-Shock improved the clearing yet. I'm not sure yet. And what else? I mean, seriously, can you even deny the existence of this G-Shock? You can't. I'll leave you the link in the description box for the 30th anniversary and one of the reviews for the Smokey Gray edition. And again, the price for this one is about approximately $130, which I got it at Macy's on a sale, of course. And there's no solar atomic on this thing, man. It's straight battery power only.
There's nothing to be kidding around there.
But all in all, dudes and dudettes, be appreciating to this original piece.
So, shoutouts to that thing of ours, Mike835, G-Shark Go, Cars and Clouds, formerly known as G-Shark Warrior 3 1111,
Benny Rosen. If you're still out there, Benny boy, be safe and hope you come back to YouTube someday. And as well as for like Mike Hughes, heck, give a shout out to all the watch collectors out there. Especially for autograph collectors, toy collectors, and comic book collectors, and oof, as well as for music collectors, video gamers out there, all you geeks out there. And again, if you guys who live in Florida, if anybody lives in Florida that are viewing this channel, send a message to ThinkGeek. I'll leave you the previous video in the description box down below as well. And also subscribe to my channel to be notified of all newest upload videos and other notifications and such. So before signing off, y'all be safe out there, enjoy the holidays, and even spend time with your family, of course. Plus, I can't wait for Wonder Woman 1984, so heck, looking forward to that as well, but I'm not seeing it in theaters. I'm seeing it at my crib. So anyways, this is Sparky Marky Mark, hanging with the G-Shark, signing off, y'all. Be safe, God bless you. Feliz Navidad, y'all.